The Minister for Urban Infrastructure.
Well, I do thank the member for Lindsay, who of course is absolutely committed to delivering economic opportunities for the people of Western Sydney based upon our very comprehensive rollout of infrastructure for Western Sydney and leveraging the economic opportunities that come with that, working closely, of course, with the Berejiklian government in New South Wales. And Western Sydney Airport, Mr Speaker, a $5.3 billion investment. You know, there needs to be 25 million cubic metres of earth moved. I was at the site just last week, or the week before last. They've already moved 10 million cubic metres, Mr Speaker, and on track to be complete by 2022. So the airport is on track to open by 2026 to take 10 million passengers a year. 28,000 jobs, direct and indirect, will be generated within 5 years of the airport opening, of course, on top of the jobs created during the construction process. And we're hard at work with tenders out for the airside works and pavements. The tenders for the terminal have already closed. And this is part of a much bigger plan, Mr Speaker. The Commonwealth and New South Wales governments, again, working together on the metro, the rail connection to the airport with a $5.25 billion Commonwealth commitment. There's the M12 motorway, which will connect to the airport. There's the Northern Road, Mr Speaker, $1.6 billion project, 35 kilometres, six stages, three of them complete. In fact, on my visit to the airport, I was struck by the fact that the Ludnam has changed significantly, with that part of the Northern Road now completed so that it no longer crosses the Western Sydney Airport site. And of course, the Western Sydney City Deal, three levels of government working together to leverage this massive piece of infrastructure. It's an integrated plan, Mr Speaker. It's job-generating infrastructure. It's about integrated urban planning. It's about business and investment attraction. It's about governance through the Western Parkland City Authority. It's three levels of government working together to deliver jobs, deliver economic opportunity. We're not just building an airport. We're not just building a rail line. We're not just building roads. What we are doing is transforming Western Sydney in a project that will deliver jobs and prosperity for Western Sydney, for the nation, and for all of us will benefit from this extraordinary project, which is on track, and 2026 is going to come very soon.